Hi guys, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well. Hope you're having a great day. And as always, thanks to everybody that subscribed. So now I'm going to be reacting to a band called Japan. And this is taken from the album. This track is taken from the album Tin Drum, which was released on 13th of November, 1981. The track in question is The Art of Parties. I've never heard this before. I've actually heard of the name. And indeed, this track was released on about 9th of May, 1981, so a few months before the album came out. It didn't really have commercial success, but that's fine. It doesn't really mean anything in the grand scale of things. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to this. Japan consists of David Sylvian on lead vocals, piano and guitar. Then we've got Richard Barbieri on synths, Mick Kahn on bass, and Steve Jensen on drums and percussion. So without further ado, let's have a listen to The Art of Parties. I believe this looks like it's a live Old Grey Whistle Test track, possibly. So yeah, let's click play.
Healthy weather.
So I'm just going to pause it there. The thing that's really kind of captured me about this song so far is definitely the percussion and the drums. It's really hypnotizing, the rhythm. I'm not really kind of sure how to explain it, but there's such an unusual drum sound as well. If anybody knows what kind of drums this guy's using, not being a musician myself, I would love to know, because I'm finding that is the most mesmerizing bit of his song so far. And getting that this is a song about the differences between being young and being a little bit older, and about having no inhibitions to having lots of social constraints. I mean, I'll have a look at the lyrics at the end, but yeah, this the thing with Japan, I've noticed that when I watch these Japan tracks or listen to Japan or even listen to David Sylvian, I'm instantly kind of hypnotized and mesmerized by what I'm hearing. It's such a weird sound. I say weird, I don't mean that in a bad way, but it's so unusual, it kind of just draws you in. You're in their world, and it's not, even though I'm here for a reaction, I feel that I am somehow just absorbed by what's going on and speechless for the most part. Loving the guitars as well. It's really interesting to see three guitarists on stage right next to each other. So yeah, everything about the song is great. I'm really curious about the lyrics, but I'll check them out at the end. Takeve, that was the Japan with the Art of Parties, and that was a really cool track. I wouldn't say it's maybe one of my favourite tracks, but there was something about it that really kind of, like, as I said, it sort of held me and absorbed my attention quite a lot. I loved the three guitarists, and I felt at the very end that there was something in the story that he was telling that was reflected in the way the guitars were. One was very manic, and then there was one that was very chilled and relaxed. And yeah, I kind of felt that was a great reflection of what was going on in the song, which I'm not 100% about, but I will look into that right now, actually. So the lyrics go something like, once I was young, once I was smart, now I'm living on the edge of my nerves. The things we said weren't quite so tough when we were young. Yeah, I mean, I kind of got that in the guitars, living on my edge of my nerves. It was like a really choppy guitar just at that very end. So let's have a wind back. And the thing I liked also is that the bass was the guitar. It's almost like the timeline of your life. It kind of represented your life. The gentle guitar represented those times when you're kind of confident, and nothing is too difficult for you to deal with socially. And then the guitar at the end, I'm not sure who was playing that, that kind of represented the anxiety of the constraints of social constraints of life later on when you're, I don't know, you kind of, as you get older, you have a few more, there's more rules that you place on yourself to behave in a certain way. But when you're younger, you feel a lot freer to actually express yourself, and you feel more relaxed in some circumstances. I'm not saying everybody of a certain age is like that, but you know, we don't really tend to check what we're doing before we do it a lot when we're young, and when we get older, we kind of appreciate that's a freedom that you don't necessarily engage with, because you understand consequences and planning and all those kinds of things. So so once I was young, once I was smart, now I'm living on the edge of my nerves. The things we said weren't quite so tough when we were young. And while I'm burning bridges, I'm burning this time. Yeah, I mean, it's, as I said, when we get older, we mentally take the hits as well. So it's not just being young. It's, I think there's less bombardment. It's like an asteroid field. When you get older, by the time you get to a certain age, even if you've had a really good life, you tend to understand the hits that you've taken, and you learn by them. You learn what not to do. For the art of parties under heavy weather, the art of parties, I'm burning. I'm living my life. I'm living this time. The wind blew through my hair once I was young. I'd sheltered from the sun. Once I was smart, we lived on the strength of our nerves. When we were young, when I'm burning buildings, burning time, burning, I'm building this time. That's an interesting, like, little bit of a, I don't know whether it's a verse, but while I'm burning buildings, I'm building this time. Don't know, maybe that's part of, if you're building your life, maybe you have to kind of burn down a few things first to understand how that works. I think it's about learning. But they're also saying it's about being, I feel that this is maybe touching on being a little bit more mentally vulnerable as you get older, and physically, obviously, where, you know, you have the wisdom, but you don't have the freedom physically and mentally that perhaps you did when you was younger. Interesting song. I really enjoyed this. And I mean, I can understand why it perhaps didn't have a commercial success, not because it's not a great song, but that there were, around about the time of May 1981, some really fantastic, massive, like, hits, massive bands coming through. You know, we had the Spandau Ballets, we had obviously New Order, Depeche Mode. There's a lot of, like, big music coming through this year. Neuromanticism was, like, riding on that wave still. And so, yeah, it's understandable that a track like this might not reach the wider public because there's demand of music at that time. So, guys, I really enjoyed this. If you want to shed any light on what this song is about, I'm just guessing, really, then please do. There could be a deeper political meaning to this that you want to tell me about. Please join me in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed this. I really enjoyed listening to this song. Absolutely love listening to music from the 80s that I've never heard. And 100% this was one of those tracks. And it just... And I think it opens up the doors to my nostalgia a bit more, because it, I think my idea of nostalgia becomes a little bit stale after a while, and I can look back on things, but I look back on the music for Nojeurs and those times that I lived in, and even though they bring back good memories, there is like this heavy weight of sadness, because I compare those days to now, which is, in my interpretation of this song, is probably quite appropriate. But yeah, we're hearing new music from the 80s, from the 70s. It gives it like a fresh, it gives those memories of freshness, because I know that this stuff was happening when I was young, but it feels new to me. So I can sort of relive those days again, with a little bit more of a smile, I guess, than now. Yeah, sorry, I'm rambling on a bit now. So till next time, take care of yourselves. Have a great day. Have a great week. And I'll speak to you soon.